What is up, guys? How are you all doing? I'm doing great, thanks for asking. And right over here, we have a quick little video where I'm going to talk about Battlefield 4 in depth. And I mean in depth. Now, I'm going to cover pretty much everything that's wrong with the game. Just right off the bat, I want to start off by saying that my last video that I uploaded actually got a lot of hate and a lot of stupid, ignorant comments were left by fanboys, which is quite ironic and weird because we associate that kind of behavior with Call of Duty fans, but these are Battlefield players and that's not ordinarily the way they behave. Battlefield players are supposed to be, you know, mature and a lot more level-headed and a lot more relaxed and cool and things like that, whereas the 12-year-olds in Call of Duty are the ones that go mental when you say something about their game. Yet, in that video, I had a lot of people come up to me and say, oh, you don't know what you're talking about, you're just bad at the game, you suck, this and that, go back to Call of Duty, you fanboy, and things like that. It was just so fucking stupid and filled with ignorance that it just made me laugh, to be honest. And it kind of showed me that there are fanboys on both sides, and there are retards on both sides as well. Because, let's face it, the internet is full of stupid people, and I guess I ran into quite a lot of them yesterday. But anyways, now that we got that out of the way, I just want to explain my stance on the game, on Battlefield 4, and where I stand, and just what I think of it in general, and in relation to my last video as well. My last video was just to highlight some of the problems of the game that I've experienced so far. One of the problems was that nobody actually read the description of that video. If you go back and read the description of that video, you'd see what I truly mean. Because I do love Battlefield. I've been playing Battlefield longer than I've been playing Call of Duty, which is something that people don't know. But like I said, people are just speaking out of ignorance and saying, go back to Call of Duty, you fanboy, this and that. But those retards will never know, I guess. Anyways, Battlefield 4. Now, Battlefield 4, in general, the game itself is brilliant. I love the things that they've implemented into the game, and I will come to those. But first and foremost, I'm going to talk about the negatives, the bad things of the game. Why? Because this is not what I'd expect from EA and DICE. EA and DICE are one of the better developers out there, one of the better game producers, unlike Activision and Infinity Ward and Treyarch. Because Infinity Ward and Treyarch and Call of Duty, every year when they release a game, it's just bad. It's worse than the one before. Whereas Battlefield has always taken it a step forward, moved in the right direction, innovated, things like that. So for Battlefield 4 to be horrible at launch is very, very peculiar because that's not what Battlefield is about. And it's a shame because, like I said, I'm a huge fan of the Battlefield series, but this is just something I didn't expect. Battlefield 3's launch was in fact much smoother, much better than Battlefield 4's. I don't know, maybe they had too much on their plate and they couldn't get around to fixing everything before launch. Maybe they just gave themselves too much to do and they couldn't perfect everything. I don't know. I don't know what the reason is, but it's still, it's unacceptable. Because we're paying, what, $60 or whatever for this game? And like I said, the game is great, but the one thing you'd expect from the game is to run smoothly and for it to be fully optimized. I mean, okay, we saw these errors and problems and bugs and glitches in the beta, and that was fine because that's a beta. But in the full release, the full launch, that shit shouldn't happen. We shouldn't be seeing that kind of stuff. I mean, you can criticize Call of Duty all you want, but the thing about it is that the game runs smoothly when it first comes out. I mean, okay, there are connection issues, this and that, but that's because it's more of a peer-to-peer thing, whereas in Battlefield, I mean, you shouldn't be seeing anything related to that, but like I said, it's just an error on their part, but I'm going to rip them a new one, as it were, and talk about all the good stuff and the bad stuff. So I'm going to be very objective about it. Like I said, I like both franchises. I'm not a fanboy or anything, so this is going to be objective. And I'm going to justify my answers and reasons as well. But right off the bat, netcode. What the actual fuck? Okay? The one thing that you would expect from an FPS game where you go online and play against other people is for the core components to work. And what is that? That's connecting to servers. That's the first issue. Well, why can't we connect to servers? Keep on losing connection to servers. Servers can't be found. This and that. What's up with that bullshit? I mean, at the very least, you'd expect their servers to work. But no, apparently they don't. And on top of that, like I said, netcode. I mean, I start shooting someone first, and they've got their back turned towards me. They turn around and drop me with two bullets. What the... I mean, this is just ridiculous. Are you serious? I kind of expect that shit from Call of Duty and especially Black Ops 2. But Battlefield? Really? Come on, guys. EA and DICE, step your game up, man. You can't be creating a game where you put in a bad netcode. I mean, the netcode is worse than Battlefield 3. And the netcode in that was okay. Like, you got shot around corners and behind cover and stuff. But on, you know, I'm sure the enemy didn't see that it was different from their viewpoint. But in this game, you would have thought that they'd at least learned from their mistakes and made it better, not worse. You know, that's basically what Call of Duty does, not Battlefield. I'm still shocked and surprised that they've done this. But anyways, you just got to take it as it is. I'm sure they'll fix it soon enough. But As of right now, the netcode makes the game unplayable for me, because like I said, you put half a magazine into someone, they don't die, and then they turn around and drop you with two bullets. Furthermore, you got run behind cover or behind a wall, but you still get killed. And when you run around a corner, you don't see the enemy, but you still get shot because they've seen you, even though they weren't on your screen, which is, again, netcode problem, which is fucking horrible. I mean, these are the core components that you'd want for it to work, because this is what the game is based entirely around. But anyways, it's very annoying. But what can you do? I mean, it's just, you just gotta take it on the chin and wait for them to fix it, which is, like I said, we shouldn't be in this period where we wait for them to fix it. It should be fixed and ready to go right from the start. On top of that, the game keeps on crashing. I don't know why that's happening, and this has happened to people with Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 8.1, whatever, like, any operating system, the game still crashes, which is ridiculous. I mean, seriously, guys, what the hell? What the hell? I mean, why is the game keep on crashing over and over and over again? Even at this stage. I mean, in the beta, like I said, that's fine. You just expect that. But now? I mean, why is the game not fully optimized? And why are you releasing the game even though it's not fully optimized? That just goes to show that you are trying to push out a game that's not finished and that's not ready. You've had 2 years, for God's sake. I mean, I would expect something a little bit more polished and ready to launch. Not this crap. And this is the thing that's associated with all the problems that I've just listed. They've tried to make the game like Call of Duty. I mean, it's clear, anybody can see it. Anybody who's ever played any Battlefield game in its history of the series knows that this Battlefield game we've got in front of us, Battlefield 4, is not anywhere near the same feel or experience as previous Battlefield games. And why is that? It's because they tried to make it more arcadey, they tried to make it more fast-paced and action-filled and whatever, and they tried to make it more COD-like. And that's only going to damage their reputation and the quality of their game, because this is not COD. This is Battlefield. I mean, they shouldn't try to mimic a game which is already failing, you know? A franchise which is already bad, because Call of Duty, there is no innovation anymore. It's just the same thing rehashed every year. And this is not what I want Battlefield to turn into. I mean, obviously, any person in their right mind could see that. The one and only reason they've done this is to generate more sales revenue. They try to get more Call of Duty guys to buy their game and play it so they can make more money. And that's just ridiculous. You shouldn't sell out like that. Just so you can make more money, you drop the quality of the game and change it. No, that's not right. You should keep to the original Battlefield game and the way it plays. Not change it so that you can get a couple more 12-year-olds to buy your game. That's ridiculous. I mean, seriously, why do that? Because now the game, it doesn't feel like Battlefield anymore. It feels like a cross between Battlefield, Medal of Honor, and Call of Duty. I mean, that's not what Battlefield should be. Battlefield was a standalone, separate game that differentiated itself from other FPS games in the market. That's what it was. That's how it should be. Not change it to something else. It's crazy, man. I don't get it. I mean, I understand that they did it for money, but selling out like that and making all the veterans and the old school gamers that have been playing Battlefield since Battlefield 1942, like me, all you've done is disassociate yourself from the market and those hardcore old school players. I mean, well done, guys. You've sold out. Nice job. And one other thing that's linked with this is the guns. They're so unbalanced, which is typical of Call of Duty again, but we see in Battlefield, which is, it doesn't make sense, but here we are anyway. So the guns kill very, very quickly. They kill ultra fast. I mean, like I said, you can drop someone in a couple of bullets, and that's not what Battlefield was about. The reason why Battlefield was more of a popular game for the more mature gamers is because it took skill to use guns. It took time to master the weapons, and it took longer to kill people, so you had to be more accurate and things like that. But now the weapons not only kill faster, they pretty much have 100% accuracy. You can just hold down the trigger, fire away, and not worry about recoil, because it's manageable and it's controllable. Which again, defeats the purpose of mastering a weapon, and removes all element of skill. Which is something I'm against, because Battlefield is one of the only games and only FPSs where you can join and you can see that there is a skill gap. If you're good at the game, then you're good at the game, and if you're not, then you get better at the game, because it's not easy to play. Whereas Call of Duty, you jump on and you can play. Anyone can. That's what makes Call of Duty popular in that aspect. Battlefield is not like that, and I don't understand why they try to make it like that. It's just so stupid. I don't get it. And one other thing, I mean, I keep on spawning and I keep on fucking dying before I've spawned in. How the fuck does that make sense? At least give us a second or two spawn protection, for God's sake. But literally, what happens is your screen is dark, you know, it's black, and you're spawning in. So, you know, when it goes from dark to bright and you can see the map. Before that even happens, I'm already dead. How does that make sense? And how does that count as a death? Seriously, it's ridiculous. It doesn't make sense. And also, sniper rifles need to get some sort of buff, because, I'm getting multiple hit markers with sniper rifles that do 100 damage. I mean, that's fucking ridiculous. And on top of that, going back to the netcode problem, and maybe that's a netcode problem, I don't know, or issue or whatever, but hitboxes and hit markers. I swear to you, I'm getting sniper rifle hit markers on the head. And some people might say, oh, maybe you just winged him or clipped him, or maybe it looked like you hit him on the head, whereas you hit a different part of the body. No, this is not true. The person is behind cover, like 3 foot concrete wall. I shoot his forehead and I get hit marker. So, I don't know. Fix your hitbox or netcode. Do something about it, DICE, because this is fucking ridiculous. And team deathmatch and domination. I mean, the servers in general. Why can't I find any, like, extended ticket servers like I used to in Battlefield 3? I mean, right from the launch from Battlefield 3, I could find servers with 500% tickets, 1000% tickets. In this game, there's none. I've seen one, or I think I've seen two servers, one of them with 150% tickets and the other one with 200% tickets. And both of them were only 16 players or 24 players. So what's the point? I want to play a long ass game with 64 people on a map with extended tickets, because the games are finishing in like 7 minutes, which again mimics Call of Duty, because Call of Duty games are obviously more action packed and fast and they don't take as long and stuff like that, whereas a TDM game or domination game in Battlefield 3 took forever. But now it only takes about 6-7 minutes, which is not what I want, because I'm sure that's not what a lot of people want. They want to relax into a game and take their time and make the most of it. Not have it wham bam finish in 5 minutes, over and done with, move on to the next. This isn't Call of Duty. Stop trying to make it like Call of Duty, because it's not. But this is something the developers obviously have thought through, and it's more of a strategy, so it's not like they've done it accidentally. This is done on purpose. They've pretty much screwed the game over and done this to it, which is ridiculous. On a side note, the challenges and the way you unlock weapons, maybe they should have been a bit more complex, especially the grenades. Maybe make it so that you need a double kill or a multi-kill or more XP to get the new grenades, because pretty much when you hit level 8, you've already unlocked all the grenades. I mean, that's what happened to me anyway. So maybe they could have made the unlocking of new stuff a bit more challenging and take a little bit longer. And finally, the one thing I do have to say is associated with the community itself. I mean, this isn't to do with the game developers or whatever, but just the community and the people who play it and the way they play it. There's just so many campers and so many just people sitting behind a wall or a window or a rock or something just waiting. Like, absolute pussies. It's just so frustrating, because you do all that flanking, you do all that running around, and then you get killed by one guy who drops you 3 bullets because he was sitting there waiting for you, which is not nice. And on top of that, squad mates. I mean, this is the first and only Battlefield I don't join in a squad. And the reason for that is very simple, is because no one in your squad knows what they're doing and no one helps you. And it's just annoying, because for example, you have 4 medics on a team, you go down, your entire squad is around you and no one revives you. Which is just a fucking joke to me. I mean, that the whole point of being a medic is to revive people. I know there are times when you can't revive it because you're in the heat of battle, but when you've got 4 people around you and they're all medics and they're all like above level 10, you know they've got the shock paddles and you know they can, they just won't because they can't be bothered. But like I said, that's pretty much all the negative things I've got about the game right now. I'll do a separate commentary where I talk about the positives, because this is taking too long, because like there's so much of it. It's just so much bullshit. But the main problems are the netcode and the hit detection and the broken camera angles and getting shot around corners and not seeing people around corners, and the guns killing ultra fast, like with 2 bullets you can drop someone, which is pretty much bullshit. And it's just stuff like that. It's just the game needs to be remade, in my opinion. I mean, there are a lot of great features in it, but at its core, the game's broken. And it's a shame to say that. I never thought I would say that about Battlefield, because it's more of a quality game. And there are loads of features in the game that I love, but the core components of it are so broken, it makes the game unplayable. And that's what's annoying right now, because if the core components worked, and the additional features weren't that great or weren't that innovative from Battlefield 3, I'd understand that. That's totally cool, because you could say, okay, what they've concentrated on, obviously you can see, is that they've made the game play better, but they haven't innovated as much because they've concentrated on the core components and the core mechanics. But they've done the exact opposite. And in fact, they've taken a step back in regards to the core components and whatever, and they've just added in loads of new guns and features and tried to make explosions more Michael Bay-like and just kind of cater towards bad players and Call of Duty type players, which is fucking ridiculous. But anyways, that's pretty much my opinions and thoughts on the matter. Again, this is a long ass rant, but it's one that had to be said, because you can't have developers going out their way to change the game and turn it into something that it's not. Because like I said, I've said this multiple times, this is not Call of Duty, this is Battlefield. Let's not change the game, because there's no need. Anyways guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in the comment section below your opinions and what you think on the matter. and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you all for tuning in. This is Sniper 474.